So I wanted to share a story with you about one of the crew members of Texas Raiders. Dan Ragan was the loadmaster on the B-17 known as Texas Raiders. Dan Ragan was in his late 80s, and Dan had a very special attachment to this particular aircraft, the B-17, known as Texas Raiders. Because in the early 50s, when Dan Ragan enlisted in the United States Navy and went to school to become a radio operator, the first aircraft he was assigned to was this very B-17, which at the time, of course, wasn't known as Texas Raiders. In fact, it was a unique model for the Navy. It was the first aircraft that they configured for airborne early warning, similar to what we have today known as AWACS in the Air Force. So Dan Ragan had a very special, unique attachment to this exact aircraft that goes back to the early 50s when he was an active duty service member and part of the crew of that aircraft as a radio operator. Dan loved this aircraft. Dan Ragan and the B-17, known as Texas Raiders, perished together this past Saturday, which is so fucking sad, yet poignant in a strange kind of way, knowing their attachment. And thank you to Wings Over the Rockies for this footage, which came from an actual piece they did a while back. I'll put the link down here in the video if you want to watch the original piece. But I just wanted to do a memorial for Dan. Rest in peace.
I'm Dan Ragan. I belong to the Gulf Coast Wing of the Commemorative Air Force. I have a long relationship with this aircraft. When I first went in the Navy and went to my squadron after schooling, I was assigned to VW1 and to this very aircraft behind me, Navy serial number 77235. And I was a radio operator aboard that aircraft. And we flew airborne early warning missions for the Navy. As a radio operator aboard an aircraft, I had two responsibilities. One is radio operator, taking care of the communications aboard the aircraft to shore. Not aircraft to aircraft, but all the HF and LF communications with shore stations. The Navy nomenclature for this aircraft is PB-1W. And why does the Navy have a B-17 or a PB-1W? Back in World War II, in 1943 and 44, the kamikazes were devastating the Pacific Fleet. We had over 375 ships sunk by the kamikazes. The problem was the aircraft off the carriers could not go out far enough and loiter long enough to catch the kamikazes coming in. They could barely see over the horizon. There wasn't enough time to get aircraft airborne before the kamikazes on top of them. So the Navy came up with the idea we needed a land-based aircraft that could fly a long way out and loiter a long way. They looked at three aircraft, the B-17, B-24, and C-54. The B-17 was selected because it had weapons on it, and you could sling a radome underneath it with a radar antenna on it. They developed radar small enough that they could put it aboard an aircraft. The problem was it weighed so much that they took all of the armor and the weapons off of it, so we were up there with no way of protecting ourselves. The bomb bay was sealed. Below the bomb bay was a radome with a 200-mile search antenna. And within the bomb bay itself were three radar consoles with your combat information center. Now you have airborne combat information center duplicating the carrier CIC, combat information center. Now instead of barely over the horizon, heads up, you got incoming. Now we have, the Navy has a 400 mile heads up. You can think of it as the first generation of AWACS, if you understand that that acronym, Airborne Warning and Control. That mission still flies today with the Air Force. For me, in the service, I was honored to serve. I felt like it was a privilege and an honor.